What's up, YouTube? It's your girl, Rachel. Welcome back to my channel. I hope that you are having an amazing day today. I, myself, am having a pretty good day today. I was able to have a pretty slow-paced morning. Just woke up, drank some coffee, tea. I was reading a lot, journaling a lot, spending a bit of time outside. So I've had quite a peaceful morning today, so it's been nice. I hope that what's been going on in your life recently this past week has been going good. And if it hasn't been going good for you, I hope that that starts to turn around. A little recap with my life. I feel like life has been going good. A few videos ago, maybe a month or two-ish ago, I was talking about how I was going through some major energy shifts with two aspects of my life. And those things are still shifting, but they have started to die down a little bit. I definitely know and can feel inside that there's more shifts to come. But right now I am enjoying the kind of more subtle, die down or slow energy with this. I've also been in a space where I have been really diving super deep into myself and the journey of my life, of myself, finding who I am. And so that's why I really wanted to post a video right now about my journey to self, but also just in general the journey to self. So for today's video, we are going to talk about how to find yourself. Who are you and what do you want? Now, obviously, every single person is so unique, and no one's journey is going to look like another person's journey. There can always be similarities and shared experiences, but your journey to yourself is uniquely yours. And with that being said, the only way that you can really truly get to that place of feeling like you've found yourself or feeling more like yourself is really tapping in to the inside of who you are. So that means that you're not going to get the answers of who you are by looking out into the external world or looking at the people around you. The people around you and who you choose to surround yourself with definitely can be and should be supportive of you being on your journey to find yourself more and more, but they are not where you will find yourself. You find yourself by looking inward and taking the time to really learn who you really are. And we're always going to be learning who we are, right? Every single day of your life, you're always going to be learning more and more who you are. But it's going to be a more peaceful journey when you can find yourself in a space where you're actively, deeply wanting to find yourself more. And that's honestly really where I'm at right now personally with myself, is that I've always been in a space where I feel like I, love myself, I'm happy with myself, I'm confident, but I also feel like I have so much more to go. I feel like I have so much more to learn about who I am. And recently, within the past few months, just this year, I feel like I really have been taking a lot of just way more time, honestly, to dive deep into what I really want. And once I can dive deep into that and figure out what it is that I want, I can start to create that idea in my mind. And then once I create that idea in my mind, then that's when it starts to then become reality. Because that energy, it starts with me figuring out, who am I and what do I want, and putting that out there, and then it will become, because that energy, is always there deep down. Your core being of who you are is always there, but it's not that easy to be aware of that or see that given the human structure that we're in, the human body, the human mind, and the ego. And I think that no matter who you are or where you are, the more that you can tap into yourself and who you are and what you really want, genuinely, the happier you're going to be, Because ultimately, every single one of us inside, our core being is founded in love, in unconditional love. And so the more that you can tap in with yourself, the more that you're able to access that love. And then of course, you know, the more love you feel, like, the happier you are, you know? Love brings joy and brings like inspiration and creativity and just all the beautiful feelings that we're able to feel in this existence. So that kind of answers, I think, the biggest question to ask yourself with this is, why do you want to learn about yourself? Why do you want to find yourself? And that really is the answer, is because finding yourself is ultimately finding love, you know? And I feel like it might be hard for some people to immediately grasp that concept, because I think that there's people that I've met that, and this is something that, I mean, everyone struggles with to some spectrum, but some people more than another, people who deal with a lot of like negative self-talk. If you are constantly in your mind like talking down to yourself or highlighting your flaws or making yourself feel bad or doubting your true self, that's something that can really, really block you from accessing the true love that is really, truly there, deep, deep down inside you, in your core being. And I think that honestly, it kind of feels like it's like this love that is in our core being, like it was there before we entered into this human life. And so it's like, as you live your human life and you grow in your human body, it's like each day you're trying to actually remember like who you really are in your deepest core, which ultimately is that unconditional love that's always been there. But it's like the human world, it's like, I don't know, like a test or an experience to learn and go through experiences that make you doubt yourself and doubt the love that's truly in there, and sometimes can even make you blind to the love that truly is within you. So I think, like, you know, right now, I don't know who you are watching this video, but maybe you might feel like, I don't feel love inside of me. I don't feel that core love. And obviously, yeah, I'm here right now telling you it's there, but that might not be enough for you to really feel it, right? So I think that if you're in a place where you acknowledge that you don't feel that, but you want to, that already means that you will get there, because you already have an awareness of something that you want, which is, you know, something about who you are. And so if you can continue to put time towards all the things that you want, you genuinely will achieve them. I think that something else that's a part of this that goes like hand in hand with finding yourself, your truest self, your core being, your love that's deep, deep down inside, is also feeling like gratitude. And gratitude is something that I am really, really, really starting to focus on a lot in my life right now. And I'm realizing that I do need to be more, or I want to be more grateful. And I do need to be more grateful to be at the place that I see myself being. And I think, like, I don't know, it all starts with me asking myself these questions of like, what do I want? And like, what is gonna get me closer to where I want to be? And already knowing that I want to like find myself more and really go on this like self-transformation journey, which is also truly a spiritual awakening of finding like myself, my spirit, and how my spirit connects to the universal spirit. I've started to seek out, definitely reading like books, but also on the internet, on like social media, there's some people that have started to really inspire me and help me with my journey, you know, to myself, because it's a combination of like, well, okay, actually, if I'm being honest, like how this happened was like, I started to have these feelings of like, okay, what do I want? I want to find myself more. Okay, so I'm putting that energy towards trying to find myself more, and I'm speaking that out and I'm projecting that energy. And at the same time, the universe is working with me to bring me things to help me find myself. And that's, in a sense, like some people on YouTube and TikTok that I've found that were brought to me, right, through the universe, putting that on my For You page. And then I see that and I'm attracted to that, and I realize this is starting to help me answer what I'm asking, which is who is myself, or like helping me find who I am and you know, go through my like self journey, my journey to finding self. So yeah, and I think truthfully, I'd say the people that have inspired me, there's a few people, and honestly, I'm gonna link their stuff down below because I've been watching their videos, and you know, I haven't watched like a whole bunch, but like from what I've watched from these people, they've really been inspiring me. And in particular, there's like these two girls that have recently started a podcast called the In Flow Podcast, and that's how I found them. Was they came up on my For You page on TikTok, and I was just like really vibing with whatever clip they had from their podcast. And so, you know, I clicked on it, I found them on YouTube, started, you know, obviously I subscribed and started watching, and like they have just been inspiring me so much. Like, it's so crazy. I feel like I'm just resonating so much with what they say, and it's almost like they're telling me things that I feel like I've always felt and known deep down, but it's like I, for some reason, wasn't able to have as much awareness that that's who I really am and what I really feel. But then, like, as I choose to watch their videos and listen to what they're saying, it's really just aligning and like giving me that confirmation of like, okay, like they're saying that they're feeling like things like this, and this is what I've been feeling too. And it's also interesting because just, you know, different perspectives from other people help you think differently as well and truly like open your mind and open your heart and your spirit. And I, so like back to the concept that I was saying of like wanting to find more gratitude, like I was watching one of their episodes and they were just really, really talking about how, you know, truthfully, like abundance is all around us in the world. And you have to like be able to like tap into that and get that awareness. And once you're aware of how abundant like you truly are, that's essentially like feeling that, you know, gratitude. And so it's interesting because it's like, honestly, like if you ask me at any point in my life, I definitely have always been grateful for everything. And I've been through a lot of experiences where I've, you know, not had a lot, or I've, you know, gone through some really dark stuff where I was like not grateful that those things happened. But I'm realizing that like I need to dive deeper into my gratitude, and I need to just really try to just soak that in and feel that as much as I really can, and like literally take time out of my day to like be grateful. And so you know, to be honest, like, yeah, what I'm about to say right now, like, it sounds cheesy, but I decided to do it, and it's literally made me feel so good. I decided to write down all of the things that I am really, really grateful for in my life, and I started waking up every single morning this past week and just reading out loud to myself what I was grateful for. And you know, I didn't take that much time. It was just, you know, a few minutes each morning, but it has really just, even after 1 week of doing that every day, has really impacted me and impacted like how I feel and how I'm really looking at the world. And like, if I can continue to remind myself to feel that gratefulness more and more and more throughout my day, like I'm literally just feeling happier, right? Gratefulness, feeling gratitude, it does make you happy, because gratitude is ultimately founded in love, right? You feel grateful for the things that you love, and grateful that you even have things that you love, and grateful that you even get to experience love. So it's like, yeah, I've been vibing, you know, doing that little exercise, you know, talking out loud about the things that I'm grateful for, and it's really made a difference with me. So I would definitely, you know, recommend, if you're someone that also is trying to dive deep into your gratitude right now, you know, maybe that's something that you might want to try incorporating into your life if you feel comfortable, you know, in any form. And it doesn't have to be a certain ritual where you have to write it down or you have to do it every day, you know, but like just the simple like art of taking time to soak in the gratitude that you do truly have for your life and the things in your life that you love, I know it will really make a difference, because it really has made a difference with me. And so I definitely just want to share that with everyone, because if that's, you know, something that you're looking for as well, I think that it can really help lift your spirits, like, just for sure. You know, it feels good. I mean, why wouldn't you want to talk about, you know, the shit you're grateful for? So now that we've talked about, you know, why would you want to find yourself? What is the benefit of finding yourself? Now we move on to the hardest question, which is how, you know, how does one find themselves? And truthfully, honestly, obviously, the how is going to look different for every single person, because we are all so uniquely different, but we are also similar in the sense that we are all humans and we are all here on this one earth. And so there are some similar things that people can do to find themselves individually. And so we're gonna talk about that. Okay, so I think first and foremost, what I'm finding is truly like one of the most important things with finding yourself is like trusting your intuition. And so, you know what? Let me look up real quick the definition of intuition, because I wanna be very clear with like the definitions. Okay, so Google definition of intuition says the ability to understand something immediately without the need for conscious reasoning. Okay, so what does that really mean? So intuition is, you know, it's feeling a feeling that is there, a real feeling that you're feeling, but it's a feeling that you're feeling that's real and that's there, but it can't necessarily be explained by the world around you or how you know the world. So it's like something that you feel as a thing, but you don't really have any like logical reasoning that's like actually the thing that you think, but you just feel it. You feel it inside. And so, I don't know, it's really interesting, because I think like why we're on this like journey to self is essentially like, you know, you start out as this core being of love and you have your intuition and your feelings that are truly you. And then you're just dropped into this human body and this human construct, this human world. And it, a lot of times, can kind of like go against your intuition or make you doubt your intuition. And I think that's really like the biggest thing. And I think that's really like kind of what I've touched on before with like the external environment, the external pressures in the world, and like, you know, obviously like society, your families, and then just the people around you in your day to day. Like there are experiences that you can have with these people, with the world, where it makes you, you know, doubt some internal feeling that you have. And I mean, that's not all the time, but I'm just saying like this can happen. And, you know, that's why it's so difficult sometimes to really, really, really stick to your intuition, because the logical world is telling you like, why would that be a thing? You know? And so like, it's a hard place to be in, because it's like, well, I'm in the physical world. I understand logical reasoning and I do see like, yeah, like why would that be a thing? But then you're over here being yourself and you're like, well, I can't explain it, but I just feel it, you know, like I just can feel it, you know? So like, it's weird, because it's like, it's an undeniable feeling that's truly there, but it can be really, really hard for humans to tap into that, because like the external environment, the human construct, like, you know, creates this energy of like doubt, putting doubt, you know, you should doubt that because it doesn't align with the logical reasoning of this is how the world works and this is what we're telling you, kind of thing. So yeah, I mean, that kind of, you know, explains about why it's so hard to tap in, I feel like, for a lot of people, to your intuition. But with that being said, like how you find yourself is by following your intuition and like sticking to it. And I think that that's probably a lot of tests, I feel like, that the universe gives you is like a test where, like, are you going to follow your intuition? Are you going to follow what's really inside you? Or are you going to follow the pressures? And, like, I'm totally dealing with this right now. I feel like, oh my gosh, there's just one thing in particular in my life where, like, I've been thinking about it for a while. And, like, this is what's so ironic too, is that, like, you know, I made a video, you know, not too long ago about avoiding your feelings, like why you shouldn't avoid your feelings and how to stop. And if you haven't seen that video, definitely go check out my profile and watch that. But it's funny because it's like, you know, I talked about that I am someone that is so open with my feelings, but I even still myself don't even realize sometimes when I actually am avoiding things that are my true feelings, like coming from my intuition. And it's something that I kind of had like blips of knowing deep down that I was doing, but I didn't feel it so strongly until I was like talking with a friend yesterday who just posed a simple question that really, really, really just kind of like put it in my face of like, yeah, you are not following your intuition right now because you have fear of perception. I have fear. And there's a lot of like circumstances to it. So it's not something that's that easy that I feel like I can just decide and just do it. Like, it's something that I know right now, like I know I have to do and I am going to do it, but I'm in a space where I just don't feel quite ready. And I feel like I need to talk through it a little bit more, and that's okay. That is okay. You know? And so that's the thing too, is that like, also if you come to a place, you know, kind of like me, maybe where you realize like, okay, like I am like, you know, not following my intuition. I'm not following what I truly want to do. And I know that it's coming from a place of fear, you know, of like others, you know, judging me or the perception, or I don't want this bad thing to happen, or I don't want other people to treat me like this because I made this decision. It's okay to be in that space and to not, you know, just pull the trigger and follow your intuition because you know it's your intuition. You know, like, it's okay to know that you're going to follow it in a sense if you're in a place where you like I am right now, where I like want to follow my intuition. I know it's the right thing to do, but I still have blockages that are like holding me back right now in this moment. And I feel like I'm getting closer. Just the fact that I, you know, it was brought more apparent to me yesterday. I feel like I am getting a lot closer, but I feel like I'm not quite there, and I do need to take a little bit more time with myself and probably with my peers and my support system to talk about it a little bit more, because I do want to feel more comfortable. And I think that that's okay for me to want to feel more comfortable before I make that decision. Because I mean, just in general, you know, like people always say, like, you don't want to just, you know, jump into decisions. You know, you want to, if it's a serious decision or something that is, you know, gonna make an impact, it is something that you should take, you know, the healthy amount of time to fully like process that feeling and feel comfortable. So I think, yeah, now that I talk about it now, I honestly am like feeling better of like, it's okay that I need to take a little bit of time before I feel comfortable, because I'm now, after yesterday, not running away from those feelings. I'm not avoiding those feelings. I am actively facing them, and I know what's gonna happen. And I just need to allow the time to happen to, you know, process and make me feel comfortable to truly feel ready to do it. And I think that's the right way for it to happen, honestly, because like, if you're gonna, you know, make a decision about something that has, you know, caused so much internal conflict in you and fear, like that's all the more reason why you wanna feel more confident in your decision. And so I feel like, yeah, you know, anybody out there right now, like if you are contemplating making a decision about something like serious, and it's not just an easy like, oh yeah, I'm just gonna do it, you know, you feel like, you know, you're gonna do it, you know, you should do it, but you still feel held back right now in this moment, just know that that's okay to not just jump into it. It's okay to take the time that you need to truly feel comfortable. Because that's ultimately what's gonna make it just better in general, because every decision that you make, it's gonna be better made if you're at literally that better space of feeling just so much more comfortable with that, and comfortable or peaceful with the decision. I think that's really what it is that I'm not at a place yet where I feel like it is a peaceful decision to make. Right now, I feel like it's a decision I still have a lot of fear with. And so I feel like I need to take some time to do some inner work and really dive into those fears, because like they truly are there and I need to give them the attention that they deserve, because they're part of who I am, you know? And if I really am on this journey to self, to find myself, which I am, then I need to give those feelings, as uncomfortable as they are, I need to give them the attention and ultimately love that they deserve, because they are part of me. And I need to, you know, give that love to myself. So yeah, I'm gonna do that. Okay, so in addition to, you know, identifying and following and trusting and sticking to your intuition, another way that you can really try to dive into, you know, who you are and what you want, and essentially another method for how to find yourself is, you know, it's pretty straightforward, but literally ask yourself the questions. Who are you and what do you want? And if you feel comfortable to do so, journal. Journal down like responses to those questions. And it can be anything that's like so simple and small of, you know, I want to eat a donut today, you know, or it can be something huge of like, I wanna, you know, solve world hunger. Like, it doesn't matter at all what you want, because what you want is who you are. And if you can start truly diving into what that is and just fully putting like your full self, your full heart and your energy into that, then you will become that. Because, and it's also, it's not even like you're becoming it. Like I said, it's kind of like you're like reminding yourself who you are, because who you are has always been there. It's always been there deep down. It's just hard for us like conscious humans to really be aware of that all the time, especially with the external world like distracting us and trying to tell us that we're something else that we're not, you know? So it's not easy, you know, but if you can actually ask yourself those questions and start to write those things down and do that even continually, because what you want is gonna change every single day based off of your experiences. But if you can just be that person that is really truly trying to tap into what do I want, and you can write that down and you can visualize it, you know, that is gonna help you. It's not even like painting the picture, because the picture is already there, but it's like putting the picture in front of your face and like reminding yourself. It's like reminding yourself who you are, which reminds me, those girls I was talking about with their Inflow podcast, the one girl was talking about, like, she created a vision board, okay? And like a vision board essentially is, you know, like a poster board or something, you know, where you can create, you know, pull together these like pictures and images that represent like who you are and what you want and what your life will be. And, you know, she was talking about how she, you know, did a vision board, and it was so interesting actually what she was talking about, which is so cool, but like, I don't know, however, you know, a while back she like created this vision board, and she was someone that was really like passionate with creating music, but it wasn't something that she had fully like been really into for a long time. It was always there, but something that she was actually kind of battling if it was something she really wanted to pursue. And but it was something that was on like her vision board, and she had like a, I don't know, an image of like a studio, you know, like where people like produce and make music. And like she said that, you know, she created this vision board, and then I don't know, however many like months later, she made the decision to actually go to music school and like really truly pursue like her dream and her passion for music. And I mean, well, first of all, it's so inspiring to hear her, you know, talk about that, following her dream, when like I feel like that's a hard thing to do, especially with music, because like society, man, like gosh, like everyone, you know, I feel like, I mean, ultimately, and they've talked about this too, like it comes from people's projections, right? And so people themselves probably feel like, oh, I would never be able to be, you know, some famous singer or music producer or whatever, so I'm gonna project that onto you and try and make you feel like you probably won't be able to do that either, even though you're talking about how you wanna do it, you know? And like, I don't know, it's weird because it's like, even the people that are closest to you and that care so much about you and have good intentions still will project their own true feelings, because we all project. We all project ourselves. Like, you can't actually help it because you have your own, like, biased perspective and view of the world. And so, I mean, that's something in general, though, that people can work on, and something that I also want to work on too, like not projecting my limited beliefs onto other people. You know, if I have someone in my life that says that they want to go follow their passion and their dream, and I think it might not work out, like, no, I just think it might not work out maybe because, like, I myself couldn't see it working out for me. But that does not mean that it would not work out for them, because truthfully, what I'm realizing is that, like, the universe and you work together to create the life and the existence that you both want. And just the fact that someone wants that for themselves is enough for it to happen. No one else needs to think it's possible to happen for it to happen. No. If they want it and they put that energy to it, it will happen, just period, you know? But yeah, going back to her vision board, okay? So she said that, I don't even remember what it was. I'm not familiar with, like, the tools that they use to make music, but it was some music device or something that was on her desk. I think the first thing she said is that she had, like, a picture on the vision board of a certain microphone. And, like, later, after she had started going to the school now, she was looking back at her vision board and realized that it was, like, the same exact microphone that she had used, like, recently at school. And that was, like, pretty, like, whoa, like, you know, like, what are the odds that it's, like, the exact same microphone? But it essentially is, like, she created this vision board and it did, like, come to life. And then, like, she said also there was that music device that she noticed was also the exact same one that she had bought and that was on her desk. And, like, yeah, it's just so interesting to hear her story that, like, she created a vision and it, you know, came to life. And I'm just realizing that, like, as crazy as it sounds, it's actually not crazy. Like, it's actually how the world works. And that's what I'm just, like, learning and realizing in, like, this, like, spiritual awakening that I'm going through, is that, you know, honestly, I feel like the biggest thing is that, like, people, when they are at a place that they're at least feeling spiritual in the sense of, like, connected to some sort of higher power, whether you want to call that the universe or you want to call that God or just the greater connectedness that is truly unconditional love, I feel like a lot of people are in this place of feeling like God or the universe is bigger or more powerful or in more control than we are. And what I've just been coming to realize is that I don't feel like that's the case. I feel like it's really easy to think that because obviously so many things happen in your world that you do not control, right? And so you'd feel like you are the smaller being that doesn't have as much control on your life. But I'm starting to realize that the truth is that you, yourself, your soul, your being, your spirit is truthfully working together with the universe, with this universal spirit, universal energy. It's not bigger than you. It doesn't control more than you. It's actually equal to you. You both control together and you both work together to create the life that you want, the existence that you and the universe want. It's like you are both, this sounds, you know, but it is like you are both the same and separate all at the same time. But it's like there's no other way that it would be. And I don't know if that really makes sense, but I have really just been like diving into this realization of, like, you know, I don't know, I've been feeling really good lately in the sense of, like I said, diving into my gratitude, feeling really as, like, grateful as I can, and then just also realizing that I'm not as small as I thought I was. I don't have as little power as I thought I did. Like, I actually have so much power, truthfully, to create the reality that I want. And it's ultimately up to me to tap into that, to tap into that power. And so that's something that I am just, like, actively working on and will always be working on my whole life, you know? Everyone will be. You're always trying to find yourself more. You're always trying to tap into your core being, your unconditional love that's truthfully truthfully there, you know? And that's what makes the whole journey so beautiful, is every day you're finding truthfully more and more love. And also what I'm realizing too, like, you know, the other day I was journaling and I was saying that, you know, today is amazing and today is always going to be amazing. And I also have started to create, this is also from watching those girls, okay, on their podcast. They were really talking about their morning routines and like they are taking a lot of time in the morning to like be with themselves and like focus on themselves and like just taking time to truthfully like find peace before you jump into like your work day or whatever you have planned for the day. And it's so interesting because for me, like for the longest time, the past several years, I literally would just wake up and just start working. And like I work from home, and so I literally would just wake up and immediately open my laptop and start working. And I, you know, decided, you know, also being inspired, you know, by these girls, that I was like, you know what, I want to try and take a little bit of time for myself. And I at first was like, I don't really want to wake up early though, like who wants to wake up any earlier, you know? Like I already myself sometimes struggle with sleep and struggle with insomnia, which is like a whole other thing that I'm dealing with. But at first it was like, oh, why would I want to wake up early? But I was like, you know what, let's just try it, you know, let's see, like, how do I feel, you know, these girls are talking about it, let's just do it. And so I have slowly but surely started to wake up like a little bit earlier before I start my work day, you know, like 30 minutes or maybe an hour, depending on when I go to bed. I'll wake up earlier and I will take that time to do, you know, whatever I want to do for me. And it's shifted, you know, I'm learning too what I want to do with that time. Like there was a time where I, you know, woke up early and then I just went on my phone right away and I saw like my friend had sent me this TikTok and it was like this cool new like tanning product, because like I love self-tanning, and I just like went down this rabbit hole of like, oh my god, I really want to buy this product. And before I knew it, I spent like 30 minutes my whole morning before I start working on like, you know, just down, you know, the internet trying to find where I could buy this product because it was literally like sold out everywhere. And then I thought about it and I was like, I kind of actually, that kind of deterred me from kind of going that peaceful route. Like, yes, I wanted that tan product and I wanted to do the research for it, but I realized like, no, deep down, I actually wanted to do that later in my day or later. I want to take the morning like for me. And so after that, I've learned now, like, I'll go on my phone, but only to turn off my other alarms, but I won't actually go on my phone. Like, I won't look through my, like, notifications or my emails or whatever. I am actually just, like, letting my phone just be there next to me, but I'm not engaging with it until just later, until I've had that time to be with myself in the morning and start to feel more, like, peace and, like, just align my energy with, like, you know, good vibes. And I'm realizing, like, gosh, this is, like, after doing this for a while, like, it's making such a difference. And the reason why, like, it makes so much sense, because it's like, if I wake up in the morning and I do what I need to do to really make myself feel good and remind myself, like I said, what I'm grateful for and just really get into that space, I would also read a lot. It is setting the tone for my whole day. And so I'm realizing that, you know, the days that I've been able to take that time to be like, find my inner peace in the morning, I have a better time going throughout my day handling any challenges or obstacles that come up. And so it makes sense, right? Because it's like, if you can put yourself in that mindset of just feeling really good, then when you go into your world, when something goes wrong and something negatively affects you, you already have that good energy that you started the day out with to help you get through that obstacle or that challenge that is bringing you so much grief in the moment. And I'm just really realizing that, because it's like, okay, when I think back to when I would just open up my laptop as soon as I wake up, when I was doing that, like, I was immediately giving my time to other people, right? Because when I'm in work mode, I'm online. Anyone can call me and I will help them with anything that they need, you know, but I'm giving my time to other people, giving my time to the company. And, it's so crazy that even just 30 minutes on top of that, before doing that, like, actually really truly makes a difference. Because I feel like the days where I would just start working immediately, I did find myself being a little bit more frustrated when challenges would arise or someone would, you know, piss me off. Like, it would just be a little bit more irritating, a little bit more negative than on the days now where I've been taking time to just, like, align with myself and focus on myself and remind myself my goals and my dreams and, like, you know, just sit with myself. Like, I realize then I go into the workday and a challenge comes up, someone does something to bother me or whatever, and it's just not as bad. It's not as negative. I'm truthfully able to, like, just handle my emotions in that situation with a lot more peace and a lot more calmness. And I think that I'm realizing that that's, like, ultimately what I'm trying to do in life, is really be at a mental, spiritual space where I'm not as easily upset or triggered or irritated by the challenges and obstacles that arise in my life. And yeah, I feel like, and I think the realization that needed to happen with me to try and help me get to that place is realizing that, let me take a sip of water. Realizing that all the challenges and obstacles that come into my life, so the things that create, like, negative energy or darkness, ultimately are a good thing. And they're a good thing because I always learn something from these situations. I learn something, I learn about myself, I learn how to, you know, change my environment or change my behavior to literally better myself because of those negative experiences that I went through. And so having this realization of realizing, wow, like, every single, like, I have gone through so many periods of, like, negativity and darkness and just bad, messed up things, like, happening in my life and people hurting me. And I look back and I realize that every single, like, period of darkness that I had afterwards, I am always shining brighter. My light shines brighter after I've gone through periods of darkness. And I mean, that just makes sense, you know? Like, everyone says you can't truthfully feel love or experience love without feeling, like, pain and hurt. And it makes sense, you know? Like, going through pain and hurt, like, feeling that teaches you what love is. And I've been really trying to mentally and spiritually, like, take myself to that place of, like, just constantly trying to remind myself that, like, any obstacle, any challenges that comes up, like, it's here for a reason. And it's here for a reason because, like I said, me and the universe were working together. And so the universe knows things that I don't, and I know things that the universe doesn't. And so we both have to work together to create this beautiful existence. And when challenges and obstacles arise up in my life, it is the universe doing that, right? Because I couldn't control it. They did that, okay? And then I react to it. But I have to have that trust in the universe, in my relationship with the universe, that they're doing it to me. Like, even though probably in that moment I will not be able to understand why, like, why is this messed up thing, like, okay, I feel like, I feel like, why is this, you know, messed up thing happening to me? This, and I just, obviously, like, if something bad's happening, you're really just thinking about that. And it's, I mean, it depends on the circumstance, but a lot of times you're not able to really truthfully understand, like, the purpose of what you're supposed to be learning. There's a lot of times where in the moment something bad is happening, I'm being hurt by someone, and I'm like, what am I supposed to be learning here? Like, why is this happening? Why? And it's weird, actually, thinking about it now, like, I used to be at a place of feeling like it truthfully didn't need to happen, like, feeling like I could have lived my whole life and been fine. And in some senses, that does make sense, but I think I'm realizing now that it's not actually what it is, because I truthfully am learning so much from all the, like, challenges and obstacles and darkness that the universe puts into my life. And so I really am realizing this, you know, cycle or this repetition of, like, okay, something bad happens and it totally sucks and I don't understand why it's happening in the moment. But later, like, I get that clarity of why. And I realize, like, oh, like, that needed to happen if I was ever gonna learn this like really important thing to learn about life or about myself or how I feel. And so I'm realizing, like, as ironic as it sounds, like, I want to be, and I am, like, grateful for all the negative, like, shit that has gone on in my life, because it has truthfully made me so much stronger and so much more knowledgeable than I ever was before. And now I'm able to go into all future situations, like, with that knowledge and with that strength, and I'm just so much better off. And I think that also kind of goes hand in hand with, like, me really trying to be in this space of, you know, just keeping my calm, my peacefulness during negative situations. And that doesn't mean that I'd be avoiding any, like, sad or painful feelings that I'm having. Obviously, I need to process those. But there's a difference between, like, processing those type of feelings that you need to process and then, like, letting it get to you more than it needs to. Letting, like, the darkness, the negativity, the irritation, the fear, like, get to you more than it needs to. Because there's, like, a threshold where it doesn't need to get to you. But sometimes, you know, I find myself, and I'm sure other people do too, you let it get to yourself too much. And that's when it gets unhealthy. And so that's, you know, that's something that, if that's something that you kind of, like, know that you're struggling with, or maybe you're realizing it now that I'm saying it, I don't know, like, you know, that is a focus area that you can put time and attention towards, you know, to change that, because you have that power. Like, that's just the biggest thing that I'm realizing is, like, I, as a being, like, I have so much more power than I really even, like, know, and than I used to even think. And starting to feel this right now, it just feels like really, 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 I say really so many times, but it feels really good. So yeah. Okay, so something else to focus on your journey for finding yourself, and part of how to find yourself, is hyping yourself up. So I talked about how, you know, people deal, everyone, we all deal with negative self-talk, right? Talking down to ourselves and getting really upset at ourselves when we totally screw something up and being like, what is wrong with me? I think that that's a really good thing right there when I said, what is wrong with me? I think that if that's something that you're saying to yourself, I think you should stop. And I'm realizing that too in times where I've been like, oh my God, what's wrong with me? Why did I do this? Like, no, there's nothing wrong with me. Like, yes, I made a mistake, but truthfully, there's nothing wrong with me. Like, I needed to make this mistake to learn, to grow, because the universe, you know, like, because if it's your intention, obviously, not to make a mistake, and then you do, that's because the universe made you make a mistake, right? They're intervening. With anything that you yourself can't control, that's the universe intervening. And so also going back to, like, okay, if you can have that trust that, like, this mistake was for a reason, you know. And also, for the record, another plug, I did post a video a little while ago about how to think positively when you make a mistake. So that's also a really good one to check out, because yeah, it's kind of like what I'm talking about right now. Every mistake that you make is truthfully an opportunity for growth, an opportunity for you to learn. And it's an opportunity that you literally wouldn't have if you didn't make that mistake. So as easy as it can be to get into a negative headspace when you make a mistake, try to remind yourself that it is good that you make a mistake, that you made that mistake. It is good, okay? Because you learned from it, hopefully. Or at least, like, if you're, you know, aware enough that you're trying to learn from it. And you also are growing from it, right? So, yeah, it's a whole, like, shifting your mindset when you're in that space. And that's what's so hard. But if you can, you know, give yourself time and attention to know what you want to do, it's going to get easier to do that, and easier to, like, instill those habits in your mind of, like, oh my God, I'm, you know, going into a spiral because I made a mistake and I'm thinking, what's wrong with me? Like, try to catch yourself. Don't ask yourself what's wrong with you, because there's nothing wrong with you. Like, that will always be the answer to that question. It's nothing. There's nothing wrong with you, okay? So, you know, it's just that you were meant to go through an experience right now to learn something, which is truthfully beautiful. As hard as it will be to see that in that moment, that's truthfully what it is. It's beautiful. And it's love, you know, working in a very disguised form, because it makes you feel bad at first. That's why I say it's disguised. But truthfully, the underlying is love, because if you're able to grow and learn, then, you know, that is coming from a place of love. You know, love itself wants to grow. And that's what I'm realizing is, like, you know, the greater picture of just, like, everything is, like, we're all connected by that greater, higher power or feeling of unconditional love. And, like, if you want to try and ask yourself, like, what is the purpose to life or the purpose to all of this existence? Like, you know, yeah, you could keep asking that question and dig deeper and deeper, but the truth is that it's the purpose is to love and to grow love. And we're always going to be doing that throughout the entire existence that is always existing. But that's beautiful, right? Because why would you, you know, not want to exist? Why would you not want to be in a place of love, right? You don't. Like, truthfully, you're a human, okay? Your core being is love. And so you're always just trying to find yourself, which is love, and go back to that place of love that you were when you were your purest form, your soul, your being, like before you entered this human world, before you entered your human body. And that's just so beautiful. Like, the whole journey is so beautiful. And, like, whatever comes after this human construct, you know, like, that's gonna be beautiful too, because we just feel that everything is love. That's the greater power, you know, that connects literally everything. And so it's always been there, it always will be there. And being able to tap into that and remind yourself of that is really what is going to lift your spirits when you are in a place of feeling down, or being distracted by the negativity that exists in this world, because there's literally so much of it. And so I think that we're all just on this journey, truthfully, to heal ourselves and heal the world. And how you find yourself is also, while you simultaneously are asking the questions of figuring out, like, who are you and what you want, you're also going to be learning how to love yourself, love who you are, love what you want, right? And that's something that is so hard to do. And it's also something that I think for myself too, I'm realizing that I feel like I've always been in a space of feeling like I love myself, truthfully. Like, I mean, yes, I've had down moments where I ask myself, you know, what's wrong with me, and, like, get upset at myself, but I feel like have always felt like I do love myself. I do like myself, I'm confident, you know, and I vibe with, like, who I am. And even though I felt that and I thought that's what I was feeling, I'm actually having reflections back now and realizing that I actually have been through some periods in my life where I truthfully didn't love myself as much as I deep down wanted to and should have and deserved to. And it's taken time for me to even realize that and even come to this place of, like, clarity on those past situations. But ultimately it came from realizing that and it's probably more, like, there's one person that was very prominent, but there's probably definitely more people too that I realize now, that I ultimately was able to realize that I wasn't actually loving myself as much as I deserve, because I was allowing myself to be treated in a way by others that I don't deserve to be treated, and in a way that I don't treat others. And there were a lot of human constructs, external environment pressures, and also, like, my own, I think, issues with attaching to certain ideas of things, of, like, oh, this is what life is, or this is what this is supposed to be, and, like, I'm already in it, and, like, it's not gonna change, and that's just, like, what it is. And it's interesting too, because I'm realizing now it deep down was going against my intuition. Like, deep down, I knew I shouldn't be treated the way I was being treated, but I was overriding my intuition feelings with these other feelings of, truthfully, attachment to these people. I was, like, attached to them in a way that I'm realizing now truthfully was not healthy for myself, because I was allowing myself to be treated in a way that I didn't deserve, because the attachment to them was so strong, and the, like, that attachment, which I felt was love, and it was, but it wasn't the healthy kind. Like, it was me just wanting that, like, I think, love and attention and validation that I get from people, more so much so that was, like, overriding the truth of the reality of what was going on, which was that I did not love myself enough at that time to actually truthfully stand up for the way I actually really do deserve to be treated. And yeah, that's happened throughout my life, and that's, like, a cycle, actually, that I'm realizing I myself have fallen into. But now that it's something that I'm realizing and uncovering, it's something that I am working on and have been working on, and, like, you know, it's empowering, truthfully, to really identify how you deserve to be treated. And if you're wondering, how do I deserve to be treated? You deserve to be treated how you treat others, right? So if you are treating people with love and empathy and respect and loyalty and honesty, and you're being transparent, then you deserve those things all in return. And this might sound kind of dark, but on the flip side of those things, like, if you aren't putting that out to others, then you don't deserve it back, and you're not getting it back, right? And that is also, I feel like, a realization that I'm realizing with, like, the energy of the universe and how life works and the higher power, is that it's like, you have to put out that good energy to get that good energy back. And the reason why is because you already have that good energy inside of you. That's that deep core love, that unconditional love that is truly there in your being. And it's up to you to tap into that and love yourself. And then you can spread that love outwards. And so that's truthfully how it works, right? Love spreads love. If you are feeling love and you share that with others, they're gonna be able to feel it, you know? And I mean, not just a guarantee, because sometimes people are going through their own stuff and they're not actually able to feel it, okay? But it's like, in general, you are giving that opportunity for others to feel that love. And it works the same way with, like, the opposite of love, with, like, pain and hurt and fear. Like, if you are truthfully in a place where you're really feeling that, then that's what you're spreading. So it's like, love spreads love, but pain and hurt spreads pain and hurt. And so it's like, the whole world is like this just mush of, like, you know, all of us feel both love and pain and hurt, right? Because you need pain and hurt to feel love. But we're all at different levels of the spectrum at any point in time with how much love we're feeling and how much pain and hurt we're feeling. And no matter which one you're in, like, you are spreading it. You are projecting it, because, like I said, you're always projecting your own self, your own perspective, your own bias, like, experiences and stuff onto others, out into the world. That's just what it is. And so with that being said, the fact that you're always, you know, whatever's in you is going to be reflected outwards. That's why you want to tap in and make that inward feeling a feeling of love. And so, yeah, I mean, truthfully, I think that that's really what all of this is really all about. We all, each individually, need to tap into our love source, the source of everything, okay? But the uniqueness in our core being, in our core, like, soul, like, we have to tap in to that love, find that love ourselves, and then spread that love with the world, because there's so many other people that are not at that place where they're able to truthfully see the love that really is inside of them. And I think that, you know, that's what it's all about, you know? And it's also like, you know, it's not like you just get to this place of love and, like, okay, I feel love all the time. No, like, you will always have those obstacles, right? But those obstacles and those periods of darkness do get you to a place of grander love that you would have never been able to get to had you not gone through those experiences. And so I think really what it's about is that, like, if you're at a place in your life where you are feeling a lot of gratitude and you're feeling a lot of love, it's the love wants to spread. And if you spread that love outwards, like, that is what is going to help other people that are in the opposite place, you know? People that are in a place of, like, fear and worry and pain and hurt and just darkness because of, excuse me, whatever's going on in their life. And, you know, maybe they're at a place where that love, you know, can affect them, or maybe it can't. But at the end of the day, like, everyone is different. Everyone's going through different situations. And I think that no matter what, like, even if the love that you spread doesn't affect one person, like, it will affect others, like, for sure, you know, because it's all about feelings and emotions. And also something so interesting, I feel like, that I've been learning, a little bit side steer here, but I was reading a book called The Universe Is You, or You Are the Universe. I can link it, like, below, because it's been a really good book. And what's so interesting, it was like the whole book was talking about, like, science and physics and, like, the history and what, you know, scientists have been trying to figure out, like, what is life? Where did we come from? You know, what's going on? And, like, you know, this idea, there's a lot of ideas of, like, matter is, like, the only thing that's really here, like, taking out the experience of life in a sense, and thinking that it came from just matter, as if thinking, like, matter could just magically start thinking on its own. And it was just really interesting. It dived into, like, I don't know, all this stuff about, like, quantum mechanics and, like, a lot of interesting stuff about people trying to figure out how the world works and, you know, a little bit of answers to that, or, like, where does life come from? How is this all going on? And what was really interesting is that towards the end of the book, it was actually talking about this term, and I should probably check if I'm pronouncing this right, but I think it is qualia, and it's essentially, like, the qualities of life. And so, you know, right now, like, okay, also something else that's interesting is that it was saying, like, with science, it's like science, we're measuring the world around us to try and understand, like, the laws of nature and how life is working. And it does obviously tell us so much about what's going on and allows us to create, you know, technology that aids in what we want. And, you know, with science being, like, measuring things around us and gathering data, interpreting data, it only gives us so much of the story. It only gives us a certain picture that's not the full picture, you know, because every measurement that is taken is one single measurement in a point in time. And it's not the whole picture together. It's just these pieces that we're trying to piece together to understand, like, truthfully what is going on. And really, it's kind of like what's been missing is adding in the fact that a huge, like, I don't know, part of what life is, what existence is, like, this qualia, the qualities of life. So, like, your sensations, right? Like, you see things and you smell things and you taste things and you feel love and you feel meaning and you feel purpose and you feel happiness and gratefulness and you feel all these other things that can't be measured really truthfully by science or by instruments. And so, yeah, that was just something that was really interesting to me, because it's like, yeah, this is a huge part of, like, what's going on, and it feels not accurate to try to pretend like this doesn't play into what's going on. Like, there is meaning, there is purpose, because we can feel it. And you know, maybe you can't feel it all the time, and I'm sure a lot of people go through periods where they don't feel like they have any purpose, or they have struggle feeling, like, meaning in life. And, like, I feel like there's times for me where I feel like subtly, like, I know I have meaning and purpose, but I'm not actually really thinking about it. I'm not actually giving as much attention to it. And so that's something that I am trying to do now with, like, this journey of myself. And it's really about, finding my, like, purpose, finding my, like, why. Why am I doing the things that I am doing? And truthfully, I'm doing them because I want to feel more love and I want to spread more love. And I want to feel the maximum love that I can feel in myself. Like, I want to tap into that max, like, unconditional love, but I also want to spread that, like, max unconditional love. And I want to see the entire world, like, grow the love and move away from the darkness and the pain and the hurt that happens, because there's a lot of people that hurt people, and they hurt people because they are living in a place of fear and darkness. And that's why they hurt people, because they're spreading what they're feeling. And so it's up to, you know, whoever else in the moment, at every snapshot in time, that's feeling love, to spread that love. If you've gotten to that place where you're feeling that love in you, and it's not like, oh, I have to wait until I feel all of it and then I give it. No, it's like as soon as you start to feel a little bit, you can spread that. Whatever you feel, you spread, right? And so you're, like I said, you're always going to be on this journey of finding the maximum amount of love, and that's never actually going to end. Like you're, but you wouldn't want it to, right? You wouldn't want to be like, oh, maxed, okay, I felt the most love, we're done. No, like it's going to be a forever thing. It's, you're always growing the love and tapping into more love and feeling more love. And yeah, that's just like the most beautiful thing ever. One other thing that I also thought was very interesting, and this was something that I found from this girl on YouTube, this other girl who I will also link below. She really inspired me with this, you know, thing that she was doing. And what she was saying that she was doing is that she is like in a space where she is, if she needs to make a decision that's for herself and truthfully for her, she will make that decision completely alone without talking to anybody else. She'll make that decision on her own and then she'll tell the people around her. And I thought that was so interesting and truthfully just feels so healthy, because, you know, the reasoning, you know, for why she's doing that is because, kind of like what I was saying before, people always are projecting, right? What their experiences are and what they, how they see the world. And even, like I said, even the people in your life that are closest to you, your family and your friends, as good intentions as they have for you, as much as they love you, as much as they care about you, no matter what, they can't help but of course share their internal feelings and like project that outwards. If you are in a place where you're trying to make a decision about something and you bring it to them for advice, right? Because they're giving you what they think is their best advice, and it is based off of their experiences. But the truth is that when it comes to a decision that's really just for you, it doesn't matter how close someone is to you, they're not gonna be able to have the full understanding of everything that is truly best for you, because only you know what is truthfully best for you. And yeah, I just thought that was so interesting that she did that. And a specific example that she did with that more recently was like, I think, so she's like a creator, like a YouTuber, and she has been living, I think, in Texas, like, you know, a normal life here in America. And recently, like on her birthday, she made a decision that she wanted to just like take a trip to Thailand, and like, but like not like it's, oh, just a vacation, I'm gonna come back. Like she took booked a one way, and she was like, I want to do this, and like I want to travel. And she wanted, that was like her deepest feeling that she really wanted. And it's interesting because she was saying that leading up to that, you know, she was actually like planning to buy a house, I assume like probably in Texas, you know, near family or whatever. Like she was like in the process and like actually looking for houses and like at a place where she wanted to like buy a house and settle down. And she was doing that and then was able to come to this realization, like on her own, like actually she wasn't ready for that. And truthfully, what she really wanted was to go and travel and go and explore and just do whatever. And she said that like, it's like she knows there's a lot of like external like pressures from like the world and like her family and friends of like, oh, is that really what you should go do, you know? And like you have a whole life here, and like I imagine that can be hard if all your friends and family are in one place and they obviously want to be with you, you know, like they can project like, oh, do you really want to go live across the world and blah 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 and not have a plan or whatever. Like it makes so much sense how the whole world and even your family and friends can really like judge a decision like that. But she was saying that she like took time even on her birthday to literally be alone and just sit with herself and find herself. And like she made that decision just completely on her own, and she booked that flight and then afterwards like told people. And I just thought that was so inspiring. And I was like, I want to do that. I need to be like, you know, making decisions for myself, you know, like it depends on what it is, right? You know, sometimes maybe you really need some like expert opinion, or you do actually need information from other people that know things to help make an informed decision. And that is one thing. But when it comes to something that's kind of like her situation, where it's like, you don't actually really need that much information from other people. Like, you know, you do know deep, deep, deep down in your intuition what's truthfully meant for you. Those are the decisions that I'm realizing, like, yeah, that is healthier to make that decision and like follow that, and then tell everyone else around you, I'm gonna do this, or I made this decision. Because at that point, yes, of course, they're gonna project their, you know, appeal, their opinions and feelings about if they think that that's good for you or not. But at that point, you've already made the decision. So what they say is not gonna influence you making the decision, because you've already made it. So I was like, okay, yep, that's the move. I'm gonna do that. So yeah, that was super cool. Okay, so I feel like we touched on a lot of good stuff today. But one thing that I definitely do want to leave you with is to just remember or realize that you don't have any less power than the universe, than God, than existence. You don't have less power. You have equal power, okay? And if you can tap in to your truest, truest core self, the unconditional love that exists in the core of your being, that is truthfully what you are meant to do in this life. And tapping into that is gonna guide the specifics of what that looks like for you in your life. So, yeah. With that being said, that wraps up today's video. I want to thank you so, so much for watching. I truthfully appreciate so much time that you have taken on your own part to watch this video. I hope that anything that I said today, you know, could resonate with you or make you feel good. I'm realizing like that's really why I'm doing this. This is why I am making these videos. Is truthfully because I want to make an impact. I want to create content that's meaningful and that makes people feel good. And it's a combination of like, I always knew this was my calling, but I'm also inspired by watching like the other people that I've mentioned that are doing the same thing, you know, like they're tapping into that feeling of also wanting to share themselves with others and help people and make them feel good. And as I continue to watch them and continue to be inspired and feel good after I watch their stuff, it, you know, helps me be all like, okay, yeah, like this is what I'm doing too. And I am spreading my love out here with the world in the best way that I know I can. And yeah, even just right here, finishing up this video right now, like I feel so grateful to just be doing this. And it's like, I, you know, like it seems like a simple thing. Like, yeah, it's not that hard to throw on. I mean, okay, it does take me a little while to set up, but I mean, like, it's not that hard to, you know, throw on the camera and make a video and everything. So it might seem like a small thing to be grateful for, but truthfully, it's actually a really big thing to be grateful for, because I feel so excited for this opportunity to share myself with the world and the potential that I feel like this has for me to continue to make videos and continue to open up and just share whatever I feel like is going to truthfully help people and spread just like the most love that I can. Because like I said, like, I just want to see the world get to that place of just as much love as possible, growing the love as much as we can, moving away from the pain, the hurt, the fear, the violence, okay? And moving to a place of love, feeling empathy, feeling compassion, feeling gratitude, and feeling patience. That's another one that I am also really working on, is feeling patience. I feel like I'm gonna dive deeper into that a little bit, and I do definitely wanna make a video about patience, because that's also something that I am really, really trying to understand and work on. But yeah, so I just wanna thank you so much for watching this video. I am sending so much love out to you, and I hope that you continue to have the most amazing day today and the most amazing week. And yeah, I just really appreciate you watching. And also, I would also really appreciate if you could let me know in the comments, you know, where are you at in your journey? Like, are you actively trying to find yourself? And what does that look like for you? You know, what are some things that you've been trying to do to tap into who you are, to tap into that unconditional love? You know, I want to hear what you guys are doing, because like we're all on this journey, you know, and like I'm sharing and I want you guys to share too. I want to encourage the sharing, because I think, yeah, it's interesting. Like when you put yourself out on the internet in any form, like how I am right now, I'm creating a video, creating content, or even if you're like commenting, you know, and typing something or posting anything at all, like you're putting yourself out into the world. And that can feel like a space with so much judgment, because it is, okay? There are so many judgmental people out there. Everyone is judging you, you know? And it's so hard, because it's like that fear of judgment truthfully does hold us back from being who we really are. And so I just want to, you know, as I'm on my own journey of, you know, breaking down those walls of the fear that I have of being judged by others and pushing past them and putting myself out there, like I also want to spread that energy and like encourage every single one of you out there to share yourselves. And that doesn't mean share yourself on the internet. If it does for you, then that's awesome. And if not, then whatever. But it just means to share yourself with others, right? Share yourself with everyone around you and like share the experiences that you've had that have helped you grow, because you never ever know, like, you know, who that can really impact, who that can really affect by sharing your experience. You know, someone else might be going through something similar, and just by you sharing that one little piece, like, you can genuinely change someone's life. And so, yeah, I just want to encourage that, and that's why I'm doing this, and this is why I'm going to continue to do this. Like, I don't really see myself stopping doing this, because it just feels right. It feels like I'm being called to do this, and I'm just really excited, honestly, truthfully, to keep making like videos, you know. And it's, I don't know, I'm really, really excited for where this can go, because it does make me feel good when I create videos like this, and it does make me feel good, like the few comments that I have seen on my videos where people have truthfully taken something away. And someone else also reminded me that, you know, just because someone might not comment doesn't mean that they'd actually didn't take something. You can still watch my video and not comment, not like, and you can still take something away. And even though I may not know it exactly, you know, I am still happy that the opportunity for that to happen is there. So if you feel comfortable commenting, please do so, because then I do know that you are, you know, taking something away from this video, and that really makes me feel so good and inspires me and just helps me, you know, keep that drive to remind me like why I'm doing what I'm doing. And if you don't feel comfortable, that's okay. You know, there's, you do whatever you need to do. And as long as you're doing what you want to do, like, I'm happy with that. Everyone is happy with that. That's the thing. Everyone around you needs to be like happy for you being you. They need to support you being you in your truest form. And if you start to change something about yourself to align yourself more to your truest form, and someone else in your life doesn't like that change or doesn't think that you should be doing that, then you should take a look at that relationship that you have with that person. Because truthfully, if you're going to be on your journey to find yourself, you can't have anyone in your life that's trying to hold you back from being yourself, that's trying to prevent you from following your intuition. Okay, so, you know, definitely think about that. Don't let anybody hold you back from being who you truly are inside. Okay, so with that, now I'm actually ending the video. Like I said, I hope you go have an amazing day. And if you did like this video, definitely make sure to like and subscribe. And I will for sure see you in my next video. Bye.